everyone. Welcome to Get My Harvest. I really think that if you're a beginner at gardening, having some kind of a quick success is very important to encourage you to continue gardening. As you all know, it is one of our major goals at Get My Harvest to help you get at least one meal from your own kitchen garden. So today's video is going to be on how to grow microgreens. In this video, I will be covering the meaning and benefits of microgreens, the process of growing microgreens, harvesting microgreens, caring for your microgreens, and the different ways in which you can incorporate microgreens in your diet. So let's begin. Microgreens are young vegetable greens that have a lot of nutrition concentrated in them. I would call them tiny magical plants because they can be grown on a shelf near your window or in a classroom or your work desk. Take a container. This container, for instance, does not have holes at the bottom, and that is perfectly fine. Then you can add garden soil or cocoa peat to the container. Then take some mustard seeds and try to sprinkle them uniformly in your container. And then, since the mustard seeds are really tiny, you do not need to bury them very deep. Just make sure that they are covered a little bit by the soil or the cocoa peat that you are using in the container. And then water your container with the seeds thoroughly. And cover it with another tray, or if your container has a lid, then also cover it, because the seeds do not need light to germinate. So I usually put some weight on the tray by keeping another tray over it. Another good thing, the microgreen seeds do not have to be commercially purchased. You can use some seeds from your own kitchen, like the mustard or the rye seeds, the methi seeds, the lobia or the black chana. So you do not have to invest in buying commercial seeds for growing microgreens. Some seeds that can be used for growing microgreens are rye or mustard, methi or fenugreek, mooli or radish, peas or mutter. I am also growing microgreens from the seeds of shalgam or turnip. The bigger seeds, like that of peas or black chana or lobia, have to be sowed deeper, and they also take a longer time to sprout. Friends, the mustard seeds take 1 or 2 days to start germinating. If you do not have garden soil or cocoa peat, you can also use wet cotton to start your microgreens. For instance, in this tray, I have started the mustard microgreens on a wet cotton. You just need to ensure that your cotton stays moist. If you do not want to grow beetroot, turnip, radish as a crop or as a separate whole vegetable, or you do not have a space for it, that's perfectly fine. You could buy those seeds and grow them as microgreens and get even more nutrition. Please do not assume that you can grow microgreens out of all the seeds, because there are some plants or microgreens that are inedible. For instance, if you're growing potatoes, there is no such thing as microgreens for potatoes. I'm going to include a list for edible and inedible microgreens in my blog post on getmyharvest.com, and I'll also include the list in the description below this video. Kindly check. When it comes to beginners, I would recommend starting with mustard seeds or radish seeds or methi. Radish microgreens here taste just like radish, and they are ready for harvest. So how you harvest them is, take a sharp scissors and cut it at this length So these are the microgreens that are edible. Once you have harvested your microgreens, you cannot reuse them. You will have to throw this entire soil as well as the microgreen shoots or roots. You could use these for putting them in your compost bin. And when it comes to the reusable microgreens, the wheatgrass microgreens are the ones that can be used for 2 to 3 times, not more than that. Are you new to my channel? Then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get notified on future videos. If you're already my subscriber, share this video with at least 3 friends of yours to spread the joy of gardening. If you spot fungal growth, you should not be using your microgreens. You need to restart again.
Friends, we use microgreens in our soups and stir fries. We'll show you how.
Okay, as you can see, I have made a broth with noodles. And I'm going to add the mustard microgreens that we had grown. The mustard microgreens have a very nice flavor, a strong mustard flavor, and you can add them to soups or salads. I'm also going to finish this dish with some ginger. Dear friends, you just saw that the process of growing microgreens is super easy. They do not require a lot of space or a lot of efforts. If you're going to try growing microgreens, please share your pictures on our Facebook page. Thanks for watching.